So good morning, my friends. Glad you came and visited me today here at the church. We got a little bit of work going on. Gonna be cleaning up the paint area or the painting project, getting that fixed. Move my little desk over there. I got over here another little project going on. You know, you can see. This is Bible study area. Got a table there. Got the couch there. I have another couch I'm actually gonna bring in, putting in here as well. That stuff it's gonna have to go outside somewhere. Got this little thingy, I need to find something to do. I got here. I have this big old Catholic Bible. I'm going to put this big Catholic Bible right here. And the sword, right, I'm going to hang on the wall. And it'll be right above the Bible. Right, so I have this sword. And the Bible go right down to the, because the Word of God, right, it is our sword. And so that's what we'll be doing with that. And then that little area will be complete. You know, we'll get that fixed. That area will be complete. Now we come over here, and I got a mess over here. So these toolboxes are going to be moved to another closet area. Get a lot of these tools and stuff cleaned up. That there can go outside. Those car jacks again can go outside. And oh, here's a bunch of junk in there. Outside. There's the old fishing basket. That will get ready for fishing. And just get this all cleaned up and made nice. This little area. I do plan on putting a curtain across there. You know, I'm going to put a curtain right across there. Shield that down just to keep that as kind of a closet area. Eventually, one day, Sunday, I hope to make that like my office. Right, that'll be my little office. I was gonna make it the welcoming center, kind of pulling over that little, I don't even know what it's called, but it's an antique. The guy would go around throughout all the different little neighborhoods. And we got it at an auction, and there was this old man go around, and with this here thingy, you know, it's a thing for communion. So he'd have his little communion thingies here, his drinks. And here you put like your towel right here, and they'd have loaves of bread there, and he would take that around. Oh, what we got here? Something's wrong with me. Focuser. There, get a little light. How's that? Better. So you take that around town to town out here in the country and have communion with country folks and folks who weren't going to church or whatnot. So I was going to put that in that little room over there. And big loaf of bread with cups of grape juice. You know, one thing I don't like about modern day church is how they have those little itty bitty things of grape juice. You know, don't it? Full cup of grape juice. So, you know, I myself like grape juice, and I'm sure everybody else does. And while you're sitting there at church, you know, you got a whole cup of grape juice. And instead of a little tiny piece of chalk or, you know, I understand the points behind the unleavened bread. But there's also the leavened bread, you know, the show bread, which have two different meanings. And, you know, that's the thing with Jesus. The crucifixion, the death, it is the unleavened bread. And then the resurrection is the leavened bread or the show bread. And so then David ate of day-old showbread, which was concentrated only for the priests to eat. You know, it's a gift for the priests, and that's where they got their food, from the goodwill of the congregation. But anyway, that's another story for another day. But we'll go through. I'm going to clean that room. Get it cleaned up. I got just a little bit of painting to do here. Take me 10 minutes. That'll be done. Clean up the plastic. Right? We got all the plastic and everything here. Get that mess cleaned up. Get that thingy there out of here. And we're close to getting ready to open. What I need are chairs. And I'm not sure. I'm trying to make our Bible study thingy homely. Like we're at home, a comfortable setting. Sit back, kick back here on the couch. You know, sit back. Making it comfortable for everybody. And I might have dinner and a Bible study. And if we got dinner and a Bible study, that would be cool. That's what the table's for, is to have dinner, but I'm not sure yet. Say hello to my little friend. Kind of sucks. I had a partner attach himself to me. I'm gonna grow my beard back, because it keeps my little friend at bay. Anyway. Spaghetti. That's what I cook the best. That's what we'd probably be eating, is some Italian food. Spaghetti food. You know, I don't know. We'll see. Anyway. Plus, there's no Italian food here in town. Nobody cooks spaghetti. The store has, like, Spaghetti Thursdays or something, where they... grocery store makes some pasta served for lunch at the grocery store in their deli. And they are obviously not Italian. They obviously have no clue or idea how to cook Italian food. It is the worst Italian pasta I ever had. And so I think people would enjoy some good pasta, some good Italian food cooked and made right, you know. But we're getting ready. I need my beard to grow back a little bit, you know. I shaved, just starting over, you know. My beard was getting pretty long, and just starting over. Get it back. Need to get me a haircut. get my hair cut, my beard grown back so it's not so full but still there. I like a beard. I feel comfortable in a beard. God gave men beards, and I should have a beard. I'm a man, right? Only women are void of beards. Anyway, let's get to work. I got a sound system in. It's not much, but I'll just look at it. You know, I'll take a look here, see what we got. It's just kind of cool. It's not the best, but it does work, and it works good. We're not super huge church, but it's a good-sized church. And that sound system will work just fine. Gets the music, or I don't know about music. We don't have music. But cordless little stuff. Look at there. What do you guys think? Got the organ. Don't have an organ player, but we got the organ here. And we'll see. Hopefully that's in a good spot. Maybe I can move it back a little more, but I'm liking that. And then we got the church congregation. But we're going to start with Bible study and see what kind of a response we get. I'm going to put a little ad in the paper saying we got Bible study coming. Read the Bible. We're going to actually read the Bible and not just read from a magazine about the Bible. We're not going to divide the Bible up into 50 different, you know, sentences written by 50 different authors in order to make a point, where we're going to open it and read it for what it is and ask God to explain to us what he wants us to know. You know, I think that's good. It's okay to do that. And together, through the Word of God, we will discover the Bible, the essence of it, the Spirit speaking through us and to us through it. And I look forward to that. I hope it goes well. We'll see. And there's been a little bit of interest from a few folks here in town, so maybe somebody will show up. I don't know. And so I'm going to be doing a lot of reading and studying, you know. I throughout my time have done a lot of studying through different sources and things of trying to gather as much information as I could, you know, going through the entire course, Yale courses of theology and different things of different forms of theology and religion and, you know, what makes the Bible, the God of the Bible, true, and what makes the God of other mythologies not true. And that, you know, if you're studying that stuff, you'll see that there's a lot of similarities, there's a lot of common things in there that, you know, define what a God is. But for me, what makes the Bible the truth is the fact Jesus Christ speaks. Jesus Christ will unveil himself to you, or none of the other gods or mythologies or forms of gods, you know, have ever done something so bold. Zeus didn't come and speak to me. Jesus Christ came and spoke to me. You know, and that's what makes him believable. He is the God of gods. Okay, let's get to work. Let's get this finished up and get her done. I always like to stay well hydrated with coffee. I'm gonna do my painting. See the gray when you compare it to that white, where you see the white around the door, you know, you can see the house gray, but when it's not, you don't have the white to compare it with. It looks, you know, looks pretty much white. It has a little coolness to the tone. Before, the last color had yellow, a hint of yellow in the white, which made it bright, but I just think it looks dirty. It's so old, it just looks kind of dirty, or this looks a little fresher, cleaner, little cooler on the whole color spectrum, which makes it calm, makes a real calm, cool setting. It feels good to be in here. And I think that's important. Just it has that nice calming effect. And it feels good. It feels good to be here. I like that. And feels good having you here with me today. the other day. And the movie was called Border. Some foreign movie, I don't know where it was made. Sweden or somewhere, I don't know. And it's about trolls. These two people were like living trolls, and they were real ugly and everything, and that and all the story would be like, you know, if there was really was real trolls in the world, and you know, they could smell people's feelings. One troll was a border patrol agent, whatever country they were in. And the movie is in a foreign language with English subtitles. But I watched the whole movie. It was good. I liked it. And you guys should check it out. It was funny. And, man, it's snowing out. And the snowflakes are as big as feathers. Let me show you. But one of the things, you know, watching that troll movie was even fat, ugly troll people have to have love. And that's kind of what the movie was about, a little love story in a way, you know, that these two ugly people living in a human world were unable to find love or companionship because of their ugliness, which, you know, I don't know, it's interesting. But, love is so important, guys. I have a online friend. I have a couple online friends. And they're all different in their own ways. And our friendship is different with each person. And one of my friends says they really disturb her by using profanity, which, you know, for me, I don't really use profanity. I don't see it that way. But they do, you know, they do. So it hurts her feelings, and I don't. I just want her to know I love you. Sometimes it's okay just to love a person for who they are, and you know, I try to be better because I love you. And even though I don't feel like I have to be any better than what I already am, I just totally love this person, and they're my good friend, and you know, it's okay to love someone, it's okay to love someone. Thank you. all I need to do is get vacuum. Vacuum this up. Move my desk over here. Call it good. Sincerely, he'll be ready. We'll move that swamp cooler air conditioner unit out of here. I gotta have a sidewalk sale, my garage sale. Probably every Friday or Saturday, I'm not sure which. Maybe Saturdays, because this whole town closes for business on Saturday. It's stupid. It's very hard to meet people or do anything in this town, because when they have an opportunity to have community functions, they kind of shut down. Saturday and Sunday, this town is absolutely a ghost town, and it's really weird. Their business practices here are not inviting. All the businesses that are here are out of business. It's a ghost town, basically. When we came here, since we've been here, four businesses have gone under and are no longer businesses. So, it's, you know, it's tough all over America right now. I understand that, you know, our government and its war against the people is completely out of control. And, you know, I'm starving with you. Anyway, you know I'm pretty fat for a starving guy. It's not because I'm eating fruits and veggies, the most expensive items in the store. If it's good, for you, you can't afford it. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed hanging out with me today. I don't know if I'm gonna get to that closet there, the little office space today. Probably not. I'm tired. It's, you know, I didn't get everything on video, but that little space over there tuckered me out, man. I am just tired. And since my heart attack, I really struggle to find energy. And I know it's because of the medicine I'm on. It has nothing to do with my health. I mean, I feel healthy. I should be healthy. I smoke. I don't even smoke. I eat better than I've ever eaten. And I continue to be fat. And the medicine itself robs you of energy. So my complete thoughts on it are, one, because the food isn't processing correctly because of the medicine. You don't get no energy out of the food you eat. And it creates a storage of fatness and bloatedness. I'm always completely bloated, and I don't even have to eat anything. And just be bloated all the time and suffering from stomach pains. And I'd rather can the medicine that's killing me and start taking supplements, you know, vitamins and omega-3 oils, eating little omega-3 oil pills instead of trying to buy fish that can't even afford. I mean, a couple pieces of fish is 4 or 5 times more expensive than, you know, ribeye steaks. And you think it's not, but it is because of the weight, you know. You get, you know, there's absolutely no weight at all in a piece of fish compared to like a 1 pound, you know, ribeye, beautiful steak. You get a half an ounce of fish flesh, and it's cost, you know, same price, so stupid. But anyway, that's my problem, not yours. And I just hate the fact that the doctors, you take my medicine or die. And I don't want to hear that, you know. I don't believe Pfizer or Moderna or any other pharmaceutical company gives 2 cents worth of my life. They do not care about my life. They taking their medicine isn't gonna keep me alive. It's actually, if you look at all the side effects, it's hurting me more so than vitamin supplements, CBD oil, and different things of that nature. Everything they say stay away from, you know, it's actually more beneficial for you because it comes without the side effects. And, you know, you can't even talk to a doctor about any other option than what they have sold their soul to. And that sucks. So, whatever. I hope you're having a great day. And thanks for watching.